Damn.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Feel like tip, oh yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm a walking Bennett, nigga. I should be a LC. I keep shooters who on point with me, just like on CP3. I was up in Bushwick with it blinky, like on 22G. Tripping out this side of the sun, sometimes I put my mind at ease.
First off, fuck that bitch that you wish she lame. She ain't me, she ain't Dae, she ain't quick to bang. When you fucking on her, you be thinking about my name. And how you hit it from the back, I respect right your chain. Ayy, I get money, that's a motto though. Beat the pussy up, suck good, I need a Tylenol. He like it when I get on top and I ride it slow. Good, baby, then you gotta go.
Hello, hello, this is your host of the Hourglass Podcast, B-Low, and I got the crew with me, Rated I.
Rated I in the building.
There you go, double I, cocked and loaded, and we got Dub O over here.
Dub O.
What's
outside.
we outside. Yeah, nope. And we got a special guest on the podcast today. We got the lovely, beautiful Miss Dae Jones.
Woo! Jones,
give it up, give it up. There it is. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming.
There you go. There you go. There you go.
That's how we do it.
How you doing? How you doing, Dae?
I'm great. I'm tired. I ain't even gonna lie, but you gotta do what you gotta do.
You tired?
I'm tired as hell. Like, I just had shows back to back all week. We just left from Louisville with Lil Meech yesterday. I had a show the day before that with Katie Got Benz. And we here to get this popping, you know?
Okay. You was with Lil Meech. How was that with Lil Meech? That's the BML style.
Yeah,
Lil Meech. Okay,
yeah.
How was that? How is he?
No, Meech is. That's a cute young man.
Meech
fat.
We said what he looked like. We ain't say what he looked like.
I said, how is he as a person? I'm not saying that.
No, but you know what?
We ain't that type podcast now.
It was a club setting, so we didn't get the opportunity to really link like that.
Right, right.
Because okay. You got to understand, it's dangerous out here. You don't know who is who in a club, so
definitely,
you just got to be aware of your surroundings, making sure you straight. Your team got to be making sure you straight. They don't know me. I don't know them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So
we just
didn't get a chance to mingle yet, but we'll get there. You know,
okay. Okay. That's what's definitely up. Okay. So you're on the right trial. You're on the right trial.
Right. So. Especially when you know, you got an eye on, you know.
Oh, that kind of ass.
See,
no,
before you knew it, you said yes.
No. Look, ultimately, I was always intrigued with the story. You know, everybody intrigued with the story. You know, I'm from Cabrini, so I can relate.
Oh,
yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
I can relate. Some of my people just came home from the feds doing a stretch, 13 years for the same, you know what I'm saying?
Relatable.
Understand.
And they BHE. So I know the story. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
We always doing music. When I first started doing music, they was the first people to invest in me. So, like, Meech them, our story is so similar. So I was looking to meet with him for those reasons. Not, you know what I'm saying? Not
yeah,
no personal.
The connection of the story.
For sure.
You know, exactly. Exactly.
Right. So Dae Jones.
What's that?
Where did the name come from?
Dae Jones. So it's weird, kind of corny, I guess.
No.
So in high school, I used to always watch the stock market. Dow Jones.
Okay.
And like while I'm in class, like my algebra teacher just give me the newspaper. Hey, Dae, here's the stock. So I'm watching it, but I used to always just scratch out Dow and put Dae as I'm watching it. It was just an unconscious thing.
Wow.
I just used to always scratch out Dow and put Dae. But I realized, you
what's
know how you be doodling?
Your name? Right.
You just be doing shit, you just be doodling.
Yeah, you was doodling.
Drew a sun and like Dae.
You was doodling. A whole nother name on your paper.
But I realized that me as a person was so similar to Dow Jones. Like Dow Jones was one of them entities that's always up or down, but it was never going anywhere.
Right, and that's
how my life has been. A lot of things have been up and down, but I've always stood through everything, you know, 10 toes down through everything. And so it was like, damn, the Dow Jones is so similar to Dae Jones, you know,
damn.
So let's do this.
Damn, you made it make sense.
Yeah,
I did.
You made it.
Because the way you just described it was like it was already planned.
Yeah.
Now I heard Dow, that's D-O-W now.
Yeah.
I heard D-O-W now. Where did the A-Y come from?
Yeah. I'm trying to figure it's D-A-E. Out. Oh, my real name is Sade.
Sade. Oh, okay. Now there you go right there.
Now
that's how
we go.
There you go.
You ain't know that. Come on,
Dub Uno over there.
Yeah.
You know.
So tell them where you from. Where you grew up at?
So I grew up in Cabrini, in the White Walls.
White Walls. Okay.
Yep. My daddy used to run it over there. Okay. used to run shit
daddy.
Over there.
Did he?
Peace out to all daddy.
All right, that's what's up. Because my uncle was right in the mix with the soldiers, so I know.
Yeah, my dad's name is Scotty G. I don't know if you know him. He's well known. He was one of them dudes. Yeah. I'm sorry, I keep
you can say nigga on him.
I keep saying nigga.
Nigga.
Get on now.
We good.
We ain't that type of pod. We ain't explicit now. We ain't sissy in
the
motherfuckers.
He was one of them niggas.
Now, how long have you been in the industry for? Been rapping.
I've been in the industry for a very long time. I'm going to be honest. You know, a lot of people don't like to be honest about how long they've been doing it because they don't want to feel bad about, oh, I've been doing this that long, blah, 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 blah. I've been doing this for over 10 years.
Right.
But the thing is that every year it's a new level for me. Every opportunity is a new level. So it doesn't stop. That's just like in entrepreneurship. You know what I'm saying? Like your first year, you probably did six figures. And now you're trying to make a million.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you don't stop. It's always a new level. And so that's how music is. So you can't never take, oh, I've been in it for 10 years. Like, no, I've been growing and learning for 10 years.
Grinding.
And now
on the grind.
And now I'm untouchable.
Yeah.
You know
polished.
What I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
I'm ready to partner. Like, I'm at that place where you can't sit me at a table with a certain type of deal.
Right. I
want a partner because that's where I'm at now. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
So,
definitely.
Yeah. I've been...
Okay.
Yeah.
That's what's up. That's okay. So, are you in the middle of an album right now, or have you finished the album yet?
So, my situation is very crazy. I was signed with Island Records. I got signed in 2019, and COVID hit. And
as
soon as COVID hit, I didn't get an opportunity to really do anything. We had just finished up my EP.
Right.
And so we only got a chance to release one single. And after that one single, they dropped the nigga. But they were dropping a lot of artists.
Yeah.
You know,
a lot of
labels were dropping a lot of artists because money is being spent and they're not making money.
Yeah.
So they had to chop from
no
the bottom.
No shows, no nothing.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah.
So I wasn't even mad about that. I understood it from a business aspect.
Exactly.
Like, me having a business mindset and just being knowledgeable about the industry, I couldn't be mad at that at all.
You took that. You took
absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
Like, okay.
Well, it might have been a blessing to you. Never know.
And that too, you know, like I walked away, they didn't bill me. They could have held me and set me on a shelf until I recouped whatever they put into me.
Yeah.
And they didn't. They let me go. They let me be free.
Good.
I started my own label. I'm signing my own artist right now.
So you're independent?
Yeah, I'm independent right now. So it was a learning lesson. It was a beautiful thing. And they still pitched the single that I did for them. So we just got a TV deal. It's on a TV show right now. It's on two TV shows. So they're still helping me make money. So I'm not mad at that.
Okay, he's still cashing out.
Yeah.
So, like, what kind of work goes into, like, being independent? And are you, like, really hands-on? Or do you just have your people, you know, put in place?
It is a lot of work. So I use this app to do a lot of my work. So they do my graphics, they do my flyers, they do my video editing. They do so much for me. I even hire virtual assistants off of this app. So this year I had like 99 gigs because they send you your recap. And I'm like, damn, I've been working this year. Like, that lets you know like how much, like they put me in like the top class of this app because I use it so much.
Right.
But I'm like, damn, I've really been working. So everything like from the contracts, the negotiations, the booking, the syncing deals, like right now I signed my daughter. She's a singer. And I'm helping her get her music placed into movies and TV shows. So the same deals I've got, these companies are utilizing for everybody around me. So I'm making these deals happen. And I'm booking my shows. I'm styling myself. I'm doing so much of everything. And I do the taxes. I do the accounting. It's a lot of me. But that's not, let me tell you, that's
you got
not
a full
easy.
Plate over that day.
Yeah.
A full plate.
And I don't love it at all, because it shouldn't be like that at
but
all.
But I love the fact that you're setting up generational wealth with your daughter. You signed her. How old is your baby girl?
She's
10. She's 10 already?
Yeah.
Okay, she be spending some. She be spending some.
No, she sing.
No, she sing.
She's
okay,
singing.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Oh, we be on her ass. Like, one day she snuck to the Dollar Tree after school, right? Look, we got a studio. We got a studio at the crib. We made us write a song about the Dollar Tree. And it came out really good.
Oh, wow.
Start them off.
It came out really good.
That's creative.
Wow.
You know?
So being a female in the industry in a saturated male league, pretty much, how does that feel?
You know, it's really tough. It's tough because it's hard for us to open those doors and get a lot of work done because niggas want to fuck you. You know what I'm saying? Like, nobody wants to do business. Yeah. And they are intimidated
Keep
by a woman.
Yeah. Keep it professional.
They are intimidated by a woman who's smart, who's educated, who you can't tell anything. So you have it twice as hard.
Yeah.
Like, I've seen it firsthand, and I'm not just saying, like, you know, a lot of people ain't had a deal. A lot of people ain't been on the other side of the deal to even know certain things. And I've seen it happen that women just get taken advantage of.
You got a seat at the table to actually see it.
Absolutely. And so we have it hard. We got to work twice as hard. We got to be twice as lyrical. And we got to be sexy. We got to shake ass on stage, rap hard. And we got to, like, it's hard for us. Look, I'm out here with all niggas. Ain't no females with me right now, right?
Right, right.
If it was a nigga rapping, he'll have 30, 50 motherfuckers with him right now. You know what I'm saying? His rap can be bullshit.
You got your small circle right over here. Yeah. Sometimes it's good to have a small circle now. You don't need to have all 30 motherfuckers now.
Absolutely. I'm not saying that, but because y'all should be here supporting me.
Right,
because you see a crowd.
Support.
Because you see a crowd like that. We dealt with so many different artists and stuff.
Uh-huh.
Because you see a crowd like that doesn't necessarily mean that they're there really for support.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
No, for sure, for sure. But, you know, support just goes a long way. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. When you at the top, you'll have about 30, 50 bitches with you, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, but that's just ladies, just people giving ladies their respect. We don't get that respect. A lot of women, they be out solo dolo. It'd probably be two of them and one of their best friends. Why can't you bitches flock out and support us like that? You know what I'm saying?
Support the sisters out there now. You heard of Dae Jones out there. Support the sisters now.
Dae Jones.
Even in entrepreneurship, because that's what music is. A lot of people forget that music is a business. You know, you're supposed to be turning your name into an LLC. You're supposed to be opening a bank account.
Definitely.
And you can fuck around and give yourself a deal by going to get a line of credit. Really?
Preach.
So it's a business. But I'm saying all this to say, just sisters in general, I see so many women with businesses and they got their kids at work. And it's like, why ain't the auntie, the cousin who always needs some gym shoes, just somebody making sure that they got your baby while you running this store? Like, I see so many owners like, I'm not there right now. I had to take my baby to school. I got to pick my baby up. I have a tax business, so I'm the same way. My daughter be in the office with me. But it shouldn't be like that if it was a nigga. They get so much help and support. Why make it so hard for us women? It's already hard for us. It's so crazy. It's so crazy. All across the board, it's hard as shit, and it shouldn't have to be like that.
We got
to
change that as a people, as in a whole, though, like that. I don't think that's like a female or a male thing. I think that's like, that's going to get a race thing right there for us.
Man. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. You said it.
That's why. That's why I'm glad that we have this platform and we like to put people as Dae Jones on here to kind of, you know, speak out to the people, reach out to the people, because you just dropped some dimes.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? And I can see you felt it, the passion in it, and that's what really going to grab the people.
You know, like, I'm just all for just us growing as a unit, as a whole. You know, like, me starting my label, it was me trying to give people a platform. When I first signed my deal, I couldn't call anybody to get any advice. Nobody would tell me nothing. And I'm like, what the fuck is this? Y'all want me to fail? This is weird. Nobody called and say, Dae, congratulations on that. Look, this is what you shouldn't do. Don't do this. Right. Don't do that. When you get this, do this. Go that way. I feel that it's just so crazy. I just want to be that for people. And that's why I'm trying to start my own label and create a platform. So I can be that access. I'm going to make those calls. I see you got that deal. Look, babe, this what you do. This what you don't do. Don't go this way.
And the Hourglass definitely want to push you out there. Yeah. Whatever you doing out there, holler at us now.
Yes.
That's what you're pushing out there. Yeah. Positivity out there.
Absolutely.
Black businesses. That's what we all about. Yeah. You see all the things right here.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. We have to. Like, we're the only people, like, of course, I've worked at many companies before I started my own, which we fail to do that a lot of times. We all think we want to be a boss. It ain't had no goddamn training. But I say this to say, those white folks, they gave me so much knowledge, and they were happy to do it.
Happy to give it.
They were happy to do it. They were happy to see me be successful outside of this. Like, all the shit I was doing, they were like, oh, my God, you're so talented. Like, why aren't you? You should be up there with Beyonce. You should be up there. And they want to help you. I don't understand why our own kind don't want to see each other make it. It's so weird.
We climbing on top of each other.
It's so weird. But you know, we've been oppressed for so long that we don't know how to support each other. It's like a behavior that's been built in us.
Yeah.
And it's so hard to break it. And it's only getting worse. It's only getting worse.
Yeah.
And so we just have to do our job with our children to change that.
That's exactly what I'm here for.
Exactly. From here on out.
Absolutely.
Yep.
That's
absolutely.
What I call it. From here
definitely,
on out.
Definitely. Thank you. Thank you for dropping these gems now. Thank you.
Love.
And I got to talk about something to your chain right here. What's the 322 right there? Is it 322?
Yeah, so it's 322. 322 is my angel number. For like 3 years straight, I was seeing it on the clock. Either during the daytime or in the morning, I always caught it on the clock. Or it'll be the license plate in front of me. I'll check out at the register, my total is 322, and I never understood it.
You said that was your, that's
angel.
Your angel
number.
That's my angel number. Never, so,
that's the first time I heard about the angel number.
So let me.
You flew past that like, wait,
No.
Like, catch up.
No, I'm going to break that down to y'all. So I didn't know what an angel number was either. I just used to tell my friends, why am I steady seeing this fucking number? This is weird. So my friend was like, Dae, read this. It's called an angel number. So it told me that every time you see 322, that means that your guardian angel is right there with you. My mom passed. And for everything I've been doing in my life, that's been the hardest thing to deal with. Like, my mom not here to say, Bae, you did that. Good job. Good job. Right, like, good job from everybody else. Don't feel the same. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Understandable.
And my friend was blown away because she like, that's your mom, Dae. I don't know if this sounds freaky to you, but she like, that is your mom. That's with you. And
wow.
And more recent, though, like, my partner who I've met, who's an amazing person, his birthday is 322. And I was like, what the fuck?
Uh-oh.
It's creepy.
What a coinky dink.
What a coinky. So he's actually the one that bought this for me. So it's very sentimental.
Oh,
so
wow,
you know
wow.
what I'm saying?
It got too many connections already.
Yeah, yeah. It's a beautiful thing.
All
right. Yeah.
Wow. Definitely.
Yeah, that's good to
angel number. Now we know angel, so only on the hourglass. Only on the hourglass.
Yeah.
You ain't even heard that before. Angel number.
You
just learned it.
Number.
Go look it up. Your angel number.
Definitely.
Your angel number.
So we got to
ask. I think mine is 007. I just think mine is 007.
Yeah, right now, 69. Right, he is 69. Hey. Over there.
69. Don't worry about that one.
Back there.
Yeah, don't worry about that one. Don't worry about that one. Don't never mind. That's another topic for another day.
Okay.
Yeah. We talking about the angels right now. Talk about the damn angels, man.
That's what's up.
You ain't shit. Definitely. So we gotta ask the last thing though. What is next for Dae Jones?
So right now I am re-releasing my EP because after the label I dropped my EP, but I only dropped it on my website. Okay. I tried the Nipsey lay. I put it only on my website and I sold it for $100. And honestly, that was the most money I had ever made in the music industry because everything is a pour. You're steady pouring. That was the first time I saw money. So I sold it with a bundle. You got a T-shirt and a hat. So, and then I also have a company that has hat with hair. So if you wanted the hats with the hair, you got the hats with
hat
the hair. Yeah, I'll tell y'all about that another day.
Okay.
But
that's another interview, right? That's a whole another interview right there. Hat with hair.
But so it was a whole bundle that you got for the
$100. Right.
But I kind of cheated myself because, yeah, you made the money, but I wasn't getting the Spotify streams, the Apple streams. And when these labels, these new labels, or even if you have a partnership with anybody, they say, let me see your numbers.
Let me see your numbers.
And if those numbers aren't there, it doesn't make sense to them.
Yeah.
So I'm going to re-release it on all streaming platforms with new songs, with some bigger producers and stuff like that, just to kind of, let me show you I can get some of these numbers. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
so,
right,
yeah.
Right.
Dae Jones, No Days Off is the EP.
No Days Off.
No
I
days
like
off.
It. No Days Off.
That's what's up. That's what's
yep.
up.
Come in January.
Now tell them how they can reach you out there, your Instagram handle, your YouTube, your website, whatever you got.
Everything.
Just tell them.
Look, everything is Dae Jones. Twitter, Dae Jones. Instagram is Dae Jones. Facebook is Dae Jones. My website is Dae Jones World. But if you Google me, everything just comes up for you very easy.
Google her. That's a new thing. Google me.
Yeah. Yeah. Dae Jones.
Google her.
Yep, it all pops up.
And that angel number. That angel number.
And the angel number. Google that too. Angel number. Don't forget about that.
I'm definitely on that.
It's going to probably freak you out later because you'll probably start to notice some shit like, damn, this is kind of creepy. You know, I never believed in the whole spirits coming to you and stuff like that. But that one was kind of like, damn, okay, this might be some, it might be some realness to this, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, that's
I'm
cool.
Checking.
We gotta check that all out. But thank you for blessing the hourglass over here.
Yes,
thank you for having me.
Pleasure to have you on.
You guys are amazing. Y'all energy is everything. Yeah. like the energy. Y'all speak well. Yes. You can tell y'all do this shit. Do you feel me?
That's what we do.
Do this.
Applause all around.
Let me get it. Let me get it again.
We got a Cabrini Green student in the building.
Good.
Damn right.
That's good.
Damn right.
There we go. There we go.
Truly appreciate you, though.
Thank you. Yeah. Appreciate you guys.
Yep.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Appreciate it. And we up at A. This has been B-Low, Rated I, Dub O, and the beautiful Miss Dae Jones. Now, can we get an Hourglass Podcast? The time is now.
This is Dae Jones, Hourglass Podcast. The time is now.
You heard it. And we up out of here.
Oh, yeah. We out of here.
Thank you for listening to the Hourglass Podcast. The time is now. Shoot us an email at info@hourglasspodcasting.com to submit questions and to become a future guest. It's our time. Now, let's make the best of it.